You mentioned in the book that I had a very bad reputation when you joined. Would you care to elaborate?
Oh, that had all to do with college, basically. You know, you were the English shake-sock type. You were a cocky, arrogant, you know. But...
were your apprehensions unfounded, finally?
Absolutely. You know, I must put it on record that I've learned my craft, my whatever leadership, traits, energy, everything from Racy. Racy is my out and out guru. Yeah.
Sanjana, you took over the India show from me. And
There's some big
I'm sorry, I didn't ask to do it.
No, but can you remember anything, any memorable episode from that time? And what was it like, more importantly, working with TV18?
I'll tell you what. I mean, I'm actually the why I'm feeling the most, you know, really odd person here, because I am still the person who never watches television, except on those Sundays that I would go home to be with my dad and he'd be surfing the television channels and you would come on and I would say stop. And I promise you, when I was called, I think it was Sonia who called me. Somebody called me to say, would you like to come and do an audition for the India show? I knew what she was talking about because it was a show I saw and I loved. So you're going to be embarrassed today. You know, we're all going to say nice things about you.
Oh.
But honest to God.
I'll try and handle that, yeah.
But it was an intelligent show. It was on the most unusually wonderful things. It was such a wide range of areas where, I mean, I just read that piece on the show from the book, and it's just extraordinary. I loved it. I loved it because I was paid really well, which I never let on, but I thought it was great. But I got to do a job with a bunch of extraordinarily intelligent people, and who were just the most wonderfully adaptable. We'd shoot from 6 in the morning to 10 o'clock in the morning so that I had the rest of the day free and the rest of the week free. And I just did all the theater in the world, and I was paid by this program to do all the theater I wanted to do. But I then had to interview people, and then I had to think, and I had to sound really intelligent, and it was terrifying. And of course, my doomsday was when you guys set me off to interview Vanik Thapar. But it was a conspiracy. Because the producer said, I'm to go to Delhi to interview Vanik Thapar, and I have to have dinner with him. He'll only do the show if I have dinner with him after the show. And I said yes. I mean, I don't know why I said yes, but I did. But nothing happened at that dinner, I promise you. I thought he was the sort of darkest sort of, oh, so gloomy and dark and miserable. But obviously something happened. And thanks to that, I have this gorgeous son. So yeah. You reminded me. I didn't remember.
Ritu, one other question. You know, the thing is, you've been working with Raghav, you've been married to him, yet we've never seen any of the strains of the marriage come out in the workplace. How do you guys manage that?
What gives you the feeling there are any strains?
Acha, they were not.
No, how do you? It was really, you never took work back home?
All the time. See, I'll tell you what, I think where it worked and how it worked, and therefore the question on how it's going to work out in the quintillion, is I think very early we stopped working together. And I think there was years in the middle where I had no idea what was going on in his mind, and he had no idea what I was doing. I mean, he had broadly a sense that I'm working on Bhavar, or I'm working with CNN IBN, or I'm working on history. But I don't think he knew what I was doing.
I've been a close friend of Ritu's for years now. Is that there is a lot of respect. There's a lot of respect, not just between the two of them. I think there's a lot of respect for everyone you're sharing space with. You know, Raghav and yourself, for example, you're two very different professionals. Raghav, you know, comes absolutely on time, 9 a.m. at work.
Raghav, have I ever been late?
So Racy has his own clock, let's say that. Racy's room in Kalkaji was painted completely black from the inside. That's the way he
Racy
wanted
is
it.
Racy's an artist.
But I mean, in a sense, the other marriage in TV18 was Raghav and Racy's marriage.
Vandana, if you had to do it all over again, Is there anything you do differently?
So I think all the madness, all the learning, actually for me, I learned everything I did on the shop floor. I remember once Racy telling me I was doing a PTC. I must have done about 20 takes, my first ever story on television. And Racy tells me, standing behind the camera, he says, Vandana, flirt with the camera. I said, now Racy, how can I do that when you are standing behind it? So no, I would do that all over again, Racy. Yeah, anytime, in the same way.
Ritu, you'd finally, is there any question you'd like to ask me?
Yeah, I want to know, how did you think that I could flirt with the camera, with you standing behind the camera, basically?
Listen, you were very pretty. You are still very pretty. And, you know, so yeah, the kind of charms you'd pull off with the Sanjay Dutt to get us our interviews, you know, true, we said like if you could just, and yeah.
Couple day.
Yes.